Yeah, we want to wrap up our news review this morning, but before we get to the NASA flag bearer talks, you wanted to iron out something to do with suppliers.
Suppliers. And I want to tell the national government, my government, we have young people who supplied even in WTO. They petitioned KICC. They brought to us as a committee in parliament their documents. They are very okay. I wish we can pay those young people. They did a great job. They did their best to make you proud, for the international community to see you can do something. You cannot subject them for, since I don't know which year, up to now, you haven't paid money, banks are on them, and all suppliers. In Machakos, in every place, we have women crying. Mm-hmm. They did roads, they have not been paid.
Yeah.
I want a system, and I'm begging my president, and I know my president doesn't know this, but I want to tell him, ask your technical team to give you those young people who went through AGBO, these ones who were given the 30%, ask them how many are owed money.
Yeah.
Pay young people their money.
Yes. And the same thing I wanted to say, I'm really supporting her. Like in the Kisii County, you have contractors who have not been paid for 4 years. And the argument, when you raise what are the critical issues, you'll be told it's because the national government has not delivered the money to the county governments for the county governments to pay their contractors. The national government needs now to come in, just like she's saying, let us pay those contractors who have never been paid for 3 to 4 years by the national government, and make sure that these people whose properties are being auctioned actually survive.
Yes.
Many of them, their children don't go to school.
No.
Many of them have lost their properties. Many of them have lost the machines that they borrowed money on. And I think I totally agree with her. The national government, the treasury, and like she said, the president's office needs to figure out why contractors and suppliers are
at the
not
county
being
level.
Paid by the county government.
And this will only get worse if at all there's a regime change at the county level.
Oh,
if
yes.
you've not paid
yeah.
suppliers and
oh,
then
yeah.
the governor is not re-elected, then what happens to those suppliers with the new...
It's a serious problem. It's like a student who doesn't do homework, and yet the end of semester is coming. Even if the guy was to win and still find a backlog of debts, and he's going to incur new debts and new expenses, it is important that we clear this mess and we move forward. And in future, there must be clear regulations, because what has happened is that people have borrowed money from the bank, and the debt now has gone so high that even if they were paid today, they would not have made any business sense by investing in those projects.
Yes.
And I'm sending Mheshimiwa Mutambo here to tell his Jubilee government that that is very important.
Yes.
And don't deny this, Mheshimiwa. This is
I want to tell you for free.
You admitted on this panel.
The president has always thought about it.
Yes.
And in any meeting, you will realize he is awakened and he feels Kenyans are suffering.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It is the technical team that is supporting our president.
And this explains why there is no flow of money.
He admitted on this panel that during election years, people do come up with projects just to entice the electorate.
I hope that is in the county, because the president has a responsibility to continue doing his work.
Yes, that is in the country.
But now
I totally, and I want to assure you, I totally agree to this. And I honestly feel for the suppliers, I feel for the contractors, I feel for the people who have worked. And this is something actually we have discussed, okay? And that's what we do. And I want to thank my good friend here, Onyonga, when he said, with the CDF, the way we do things, we do things that you will never get any questions, all right? When we come to our clock, it ticks. We are done.
Yeah.
The same thing need to happen in two
counties.
But now my question which I raised is, how are we going to get the minister handle county issues without the framework of the law? This is the only issue. And that's what we need to come in with speed and make sure that we give the minister, the treasury, I mean, some working document, so that even if it is retaining some of the money which is supposed to go to county, to tell the counties, bring whatever you are owed so that we can sort it from here.
But the control of budget can also do that.
Yeah.
And she has the powers to do that.
Yes. Sorry?
The control of budget has the powers, because she's the one who releases and says, this good, and she's the one also to look.
But she may not have the audit of how many debts are held in
I'm not saying about that.
You see?
But she has the power to safeguard those resources.
No.
Let us safeguard these contractors, because my understanding is during this transition period there will be a lot of wastage. Agnes has been very good in this.
Yes. If she knows that the country is not doing right, she always safeguards the money.
Okay.
And she needs to just look at the way she safeguarded Makueni.
Yes.
When they had their problems, I think she can come in and look at and realize, I know we have all these challenges, the Auditor General can also, and then Treasury assists them and becomes the mother to take care
but
of
them. But I'm afraid here, my sister, whatever we are saying here, we may bring a lot of problem to her, because tomorrow morning, people may wake up in our office with all the debts in our office, claiming that, you know, we saw Mutambo and Alachi discussing this and we need to be paid.
Let the law be followed.
Okay. I would still insist the law to be followed.
Ladies and gentlemen, I beg that we switch the discussion because our time is almost up.
Yes.
And there's this issue about the NASA flag bearer that has been swept under the carpet since we went, we started this nominations process. Of course, probably we'll revisit it in full next week after the nominations are done. Of course, hoping that the Jubilee Party nominations will not have a lot. Why are you laughing, Senator? Because seeing what has happened in Busia and other places, we do expect even the Jubilee Party primaries will have some aftershocks, which may take some time.
Nakuru will manage. Nakuru is the bedrock of the aftershocks.
So, and that only means that the discussions about NASA flag bearer, and this is what they want, that for the public to public interest on this matter to be diverted to the party primaries, but the Standard has done us a favor and reintroduced that discussion today, and so we have no option but to discuss it, because now it is on the headlines. NASA flag bearer talks. We were promised that the four principals were to go on a retreat beginning 17th. Today is actually 18th.
Yes.
17th to 19th, a 3-day retreat, and come up with one. Now this is 18th. We understand those talks did not take off. Raila Odinga is said to be in South Africa. The WIPO party leader was in Dubai, came back yesterday when the talks should have already started. Amani, a national leader, was here, but of course he cannot go to the talks with Moses Wetangula alone. Now we also do understand that part of the issue is the inclusion of Bomet Governor Isaac Ruto in these talks. It was to be a 4-man discussion. Now we understand it will be 5. Where are we on this?
Well, one, I think there is so much rumor. Mheshimiwa Kalonzo came from Dubai on Friday evening and he's been in town. So it is not entirely true that he came back from Dubai yesterday. Number two, Raila went to South Africa on family issues, and he was expected to come back last evening. We were envisaging today the governor of Bomet was going to join us, but he has not come because he's meeting elders in Bomet today. And tomorrow, his party nomination will be taking shape, and he's going to vote. After voting, he will come to Nairobi. And when he gets to Nairobi, I'm sure the principals will have prepared so that we partner with him and we move forward. So this issue of failed talks is just a figment of imagination of some people who choose just to imagine and create a story, like the way Mheshimiwa will create this story that we have failed to talk. We are ongoing. This evening, NCC, which I'm a member of, is going to finalize with the report, because we told our leaders, go to the retreat armed with all the information about the things that we said we are going to do.
Which report is they're waiting for now?
The report from NCC.
You had already given that report. The
no.
Last time you were here, you said
there was no report. There was leakage of one of the permutations.
Okay.
There were 12 permutations. Somebody conveniently decided to leak one of them.
Oh, so the report,
the total report will be handed over to them, so that they go to the retreat informed by the discussions that we have had for the last
So when months. You were coming up with this date of 17th to 19th, you were not ready for that?
Not that we are not ready. Family issues come in.
Mm-hmm.
The issue of Easter came in. The issue of Bomet Governor came in. And we want to move together with him.
And that issue of Bomet Governor, how did that come in?
In terms of what?
His inclusion into the...
He's part of us.
He's part of us.
You remember I've gone to Bomet twice.
Yes.
And Mheshimiwa Raila has gone to Bomet a number of times with his colleagues. Because now the understanding is that part of the delay and part of the failure to have the meeting yesterday was occasioned by the inclusion.
Let's assume, you know, we are to receive him today. Mm-hmm. So let's assume even Raila was here last evening. They would not have gone to the retreat because we was going to receive him today.
Mm-hmm.
Now we are receiving him tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
So after that, that is when now they will decide how to move. But more fundamentally, we are dealing with nominations across party.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think it's the right time even to deal with the flag bearer at this stage, or can we deal with party nominations?
Mm-hmm.
Then we give you the candidate before the end of the month.
But when I was here, you're the ones who gave us the date, 17th, 19th.
That is the retreat.
You are aware that
is the retreat. And we can decide not even to have that retreat away.
Mm-hmm.
We can decide to do it in Nairobi.
Mm-hmm.
Why are you so concerned that you must see us flying out of Nairobi
for me, I don't want to look at it that way.
Yes.
I want to now look at it critically, because I think in NASA, the biggest challenge they face is not who will be the flag bearer.
Mm-hmm.
The biggest challenge they face is the electorate behind them that is really pushing each of them to be mm-hmm. a presidential candidate. And in either way, whoever takes, there will be a fallout in the others, not on them, on their electorate. Because their electorate have been very loyal to them for the last 20 years,
mm-hmm.
and they are wondering, do I still have to be with you? 20 years you have shown me this thing,
mm-hmm.
and it is not working. I am telling you, move. I want to see you this way. And that is the biggest challenge of especially the two. When I come now at the three, because also my brother and my leader, Musalia Mudavadi,
mm-hmm.
is facing a behind electorate that is not joking.
Mm-hmm.
That they are saying, if you are not the flag bearer, you are alone with this thing. And the same thing with Kalonzo. So in totality, this time round, it is not the leader saying what they want.
Mm-hmm.
It is the electorate speaking and saying, we don't want this. We are telling you we want this. That is their biggest challenge, and they will have to face it very difficultly. But let them just know, in between all, they will have a fallout. Mm-hmm. On their electorate themselves.
Well, that's a prayer. That's a prayer given the fact that she's in Jubilee.
No, it's not my prayer.
That's why we spend 2 months discussing this issue.
Yes.
We know there is no way that you can have 100%. And you know, statistics abound that if you are the presidential candidate, there is a better turnout in your backyard.
Mm-hmm.
If you are running mate, the turnout is lower by.
And that's what you've handled in your report.
What we've been handling in our report.
Let me give an example. In 2007,
yes.
Deputy President was the last person to join ODM. Mm-hmm. He was told by the electorate, we have gone.
Mm-hmm.
You remain there. Find us. He was the last to join that thing.
But
yes, that is true.
But you see, also our supporters, they have told us, give us now, regardless of who we are willing to support.
Which supporters? From where? Not from Ukambani.
It's Bwana Onyonka's turn.
Allow me, please. There are two things I want to deal with. Item number one, on behalf of the Party of Ford Kenya, where Moses Wetangula is actually a principal. There was a story in the paper yesterday which was saying that he had run away, you saw it, from the meeting which was being held. There was no story like that. The truth is, and this is what I would like to mention to our brothers in Jubilee,
Especially the truth is
NASA is actually forming itself, and NASA is actually going to consolidate. All the stories you hear about how the members of the fraternity from NASA, the four principals, it looks like they are not going to be together, their members are not supporting them. In fact, if Kalonzo doesn't run, the Kambas will run away. The fact is, as I speak right now, and I'm making an assumption that the Kenyan voter is now rational, they're actually saying NASA is a formidable force to challenge Jubilee on any matter as we speak. And the reality that is there, if there's going to be fallout all out of this, it might just be about 5 to 10%. The truth is, if these four individuals, plus my comrade who I was in the university with, Isaac Ruto, if he comes onto this group, I think then we are going to have a titanic battle between the two groups.
Yeah.
The only thing that many of us are praying for is that we will actually have a very peaceful campaign, that your nominations in Jubilee are going to be successful, and for the NASA teams, even when there is competition already for Kenya, we have already done our nominations, and in fact our members, most of them are very happy, and some of them who have issues, the party is sorting that out. ANC, they are doing the same thing, their candidates are coming on board and things are being sorted out. The NASA family, as I look at it, anybody in Jubilee who dismisses this group and makes an assumption that in case Raila becomes the presidential candidate or Kalonzo, then the members of the Luo community, if it is Kalonzo, they will run away, or if it is Musalia, the other groups will run away. The voters, when you go to the grassroots, they are saying, give us the candidate, we are now ready.
Let me tell you the truth. And that is what my
bishop,
that and that is what my good friend is running away from. And actually is a culprit to this. Right? Remember, Onyonka was with us in a Jubilee. And his elector told him, you know, go there, just a minute, let me make my point to you. Let me make my point. His elector told him, can you let me make my point? His elector told him, listen, if you go there, we will not elect you. I saw him somewhere on a newspaper, he was pictured seated down with the Baba, okay, going back to NASA. Why? Because the people on the ground have said this. What am I saying? The point is this, and what is making this talk not to be there? Right? It is the power of the people, from where those principles come from. And I'll tell you from Ukambani, I'll tell you from Luo Nyanza, I'll tell you from other areas.
You are now in Luo.
You see, I'll tell you. You see, because Kambasa, and we were the pioneers. Actually, I was the first person who said, if there's no Kalonzo, there's no code. By then it was code.
And the ones telling Kalonzo not to run away. They are telling him, if you run away, you're cooked.
No. Actually, it is new.
They are telling Musalia not run away.
No. It is new.
No code. Stick it in there.
Gentlemen, let's do this orderly.
There are no talks. And we know
there are talks.
There are talks.
Talks where? I have a question, gentlemen. Now that you're seeing things are changing, we're having the inclusion of the Met Governor Isaac Ruto. That particular dynamic, what does it mean? Because already when there were the four of them, there were already issues about how, if at all, NASA takes over, they're going to share power. Now we're seeing the inclusion of Isaac Ruto. What informs that? What does he bring to the table? Yeah, we know his position as governor, we know his position in Rift Valley, we know his squabbles with the deputy president. What exactly does he bring to the table? Is it just a footprint, having a footprint within Rift Valley?
No. Of course, even without Governor Ruto, NASA is already in Rift Valley. Remember, there are a number of counties where governors are in NASA, including my own county, Trans Nzoia, Turkana, and several other places where we got substantial votes. But the inclusion of Isaac is a very important thing as far as we are concerned, as a Kalenjin, because that's the face of the Kalenjin leadership. And Isaac is a very formidable player. His cousin, William, may be the deputy president, but you cannot wish him away, both in Bomet and anywhere else, even in Nandi and even in Trans Nzoia, where I come from. But what is fundamental about this is that NASA, we have said, we are all inclusive. And any person who wants to join us, we receive him with both arms.
It is actually giving him a seat at the table.
The issue is, I want you to understand, he's going to run for governor.
Yes.
He's not going to struggle for which part of the cake am I going to get as a piece. But more important, look at that statement by Standard. And you know, this is something that the media also must guard. The word they have used in the second page, saying Isaac's dalliance with NASA. No, it's somewhere here. Where is it? Isaac's...
Because the story is actually should be on page 9.
Page 9. They have used the word that for those dalliance, you know, that is... It's romance about love relationship, and you know, and they are saying it's a gamble. In politics, it's always a gamble. Even Jubilee today, they may be so confident that they are going to win. But August, it is the hand of God that will provide the leader of Kenya.
So why are they spending so much time doing a bidding for one coalition instead of doing objective journalistic reporting?
Okay. This is something. The inclusion of Isaac Ruto in that.
It's in a very interesting scenario where now, and I want to tell NASA that fine, will Isaac Ruto comes in. He brings in, as Waziri says, believes that he brings in the face of Rift Valley, which is okay. But I want to tell you for free, the electorate is not as as you think. Electorate is also looking beyond. And I want to tell my brother Isaac Ruto, you want to vote for the governor of Bomet, bringing in yourself here puts you at a very high level. You must ensure also your candidate will feel comfortable wherever they are vying. I mean, let's be realistic. Let us not lie to ourselves that, and you might find because of that.
You're talking about his Chama Cha Mashinani candidates.
Yes, now those who are now Chama Cha Mashinani, because maybe they didn't want to go through nominations and everything, some of them, you might find them now fearing again and saying, now look here, this guy now, when he goes to this, we are done. In our, and it is true, because politics is propaganda. People are just going to use it. And I want to tell, for Isaac, it's not propaganda. He has decided he wants to be with the opposition. In Bomet, they should just see that.
Okay.
That
but the inclusion of Isaac Ruto.
Kube, he has been always in the opposition. He has just been lying to them.
I will tell you this. I will tell you this. But any politician will tell you that when you get a catch like Isaac Ruto, whether he is going to bring you 200,000 votes or not, even if he just brought 50,000, that is actually what NASA requires.
It's just about a matter of perception?
It's a matter of perception, number one. That means that Rift Valley is having a rethink and is having a revaluation of its engagement with the Jubilee government, even when the deputy president exists, and there's a likelihood, the argument that is going to be out there is that, look, I am second to the throne. And it will be actually a mistake.
Which throne?
No. I'm saying, get my argument, that deputy president would argue, and his people would argue, that he is number two to President Uhuru.
Yes.
Yeah.
And therefore, he would make a very good case that, look, so long as Uhuru wins this time around, next is going to be me. But that is if the Kalenjin vote, especially the South Rift, will believe that after President Uhuru is out of office, then the deputy will take over.
Yes.
The question then becomes, what if he doesn't?
Yes.
Yeah. But
number
also,
two, when you take the vote from South Rift, and then you see what NASA has done in Meru, then you see what has happened in Coast and the Kilifi areas and all these other areas, and you look at Northeastern, I would actually, if I was a political strategist for the Jubilee team, I would be redoing my numbers right now.
Yes.
Before that.
But also allow me to say what I know.
Yes. As you wrap up.
Just give me an opportunity I want to tell my Shinua. As Jubilee, I will not be doing that strategy you're saying. Because one, as Jubilee, I know I was never in Coast. I am in Coast now. I know I was never in the whole of Northeastern. I have taken it now on. So for Jubilee, what I will ask them is look at your stronghold and ensure it is intact. For Isaac Ruto, I want to tell my Kalenjin brothers and sisters, you have your brother who is our deputy president, who is there now, deputy president. This guy is just governor. I am wondering how he'll come in and resolve all your issues.
That is the point I wanted to hammer. You know, we are making a lot of assumptions and undermining the diligence of the Kalenjins.
They understand very well
they have a deputy president on their hands. They have.
Yes.
You are telling them to throw what they have and go for, to look for something they don't have. That is the point number one. Number two, inclusion of my machinery guy.
Yeah.
It's just adding confusion.
No, remember,
guys, they could not agree when they were three. Then they added another Mudavadi. They became four. Confusion became worse. Now they have added five. So, I mean, it's a clear
You are enlarging the family.
Okay.
I'll give you a chance, because seniority will allow Bwana Kipruto to wrap up this conversation.
Without your respect.
I don't want to disagree with my sister, and that analysis is correct to a certain extent. But you see, there are a number of factors that they are forgetting. One is that the deputy president is the deputy president of Kenya. Now is held office. In 2013,
they were elected on one ticket called the ICC with Uhuru. Now that ticket is not there. Today, he has been tested on performance or lack of it. And therefore, there are certain discontent in the grassroots that he may not be able to address.
Mm-hmm.
Number three, ISAC has been consulting. We've gone to a number of meetings consulting with these people. And there were the two alternatives, either NASA or Jubilee. And it is the people of Bomet and other counties, 20 counties, 20 constituencies, that told him, let us go the NASA way.
Okay.
So that is the position,
uh-huh.
and that is what we are expecting tomorrow.
Okay.
But finally, remember, this election is not going to be won on absolute numbers of the party that you have. It depends on the small parties that you bring on board.
Mm-hmm.
The last election, the difference between Uhuru's votes and those who did not vote for him was 8,000 votes.
Mm-hmm.
So this time round, even 5,000 votes from Bomet
it
may make the difference.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Bwana Kipruto Arap Kirwa, Deputy Party Leader ANC, also an aspirant for the Trans-Nzoia Senate seat. Next to him, Joe Mutambu, MP Mwingi Central. On my right, Senator Beatrice Elachi, aspirant for the Dagoretti North MP seat, and Richard Onyonka, MP Kitutu Church, helping us look at the headlines this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, that has been our news review. Of course, Man Cave is coming up right next with Willis Waburu. They'll be discussing cheating in relationships. You do not want to miss that conversation this morning. But for me, my name is Freddy Ndimule. Good morning.